Scholars are those who burn with a passion and pursue their dreams with sincerity in order to achieve a distinct place among the surging crowd and silent spectators. A very pleasant morning and a hearty welcome to you all. We are immensely privileged to have amidst us Chairman Sir Dr. Bijoy Kumar Sahu, Principal Sir Sri Harish Sandhuja, Vice Principal Sir Secondary Shikala Kalinga Rudra Panda, Headmaster of SAI International Residential School, Sri Sanjeev Batla, parents, guests, teachers, and dear students. I, on behalf of the SAI fraternity, extend a very warm welcome to you all to the prestigious Scholar Badge Ceremony 2017. At the outset, let me give a big congratulations to all the proud Scholar Badge holders. The Scholar Badge is the epitome and a clear reflection of the hard work, perseverance, self-discipline, prudent approach, and unflinching determination to reach the zenith of success. The proud achievers have conclusively proved that with the invincible willpower, they could transform their dreams into reality. Their incessant toil in the pursuit of their goal has reaped rich dividends. We witness in the budding pioneers the innate abilities to carve a niche for themselves among multitudes.
Good morning to the parents and the grandparents. Thank you for finding time and being here with us today. It's an honor for us to welcome you here, and on this auspicious occasion, I would say, where we are felicitating the children who have achieved academically certain goals. I believe this is what is called tapasya. Tapasya is this, that when you work hard and you try to achieve something, and this is not which is visible to everyone in the world. It is done all alone when you are in the realms of your house, home, working hard in the evening, not going out sometimes, compromising with certain desires, and then you try to achieve something. And then finally you get a goal. This is what is called tapasya, and I congratulate all these children, the proud pioneers and their parents for making this occasion a proud moment for all of us. Thank you. I would also like to tell you that we thought that it is apt that when the state of Odisha is celebrating the Asian Athletics Championship, we must have a welcome dance, something which is also representing the same. So that is why we had these kids performing this particular dance, because we wanted it to be coincidental with Asian Athletics Championship. Thank you, kids, for doing that, and thanks to the dance teachers. And now I would like to share with you some of the glimpses of the annual academic performance that the SAI International Schools seems to have achieved. So it's very important that you should know what the children who are moving out of the school, the badges of class 10 and 12, how they are doing and performing. So to share with you the first thing, as the trend has been from last few years now, I'm so happy and proud to share with you that this time the Eastern Region topper was from SAI International School of Commerce, 98.4%, Soumya Sambhavi, and she actually got out of 500, 492 marks. So she only lost 8 marks in 5 subjects. And that is, I think, achievable because there is a lot of devotion, and we believe that holistic parenting does not imply only to be mediocres. It implies to produce excellence. And that is what we are trying to achieve. And similarly, if you see, the children who were just behind them were not very far off. Neha Moda with 97.6%, Shivangi Agarwal with 96.6%, Anant Dalmia with 96.6%. If I show you this report card of the total number of candidates who were there in the commerce stream was 181. 100% student passed. 75% and above students were 149 out of 181, which was approximately 82.3%. 90% and above marks were obtained by 61 students, which is close to 33.7%, which implies that out of 100 children, or out of 3, one child was getting above 90% aggregate marks in class 12 commerce. So this is something which was really a very big thing. 84.1 was the commerce stream average. Similarly, in the science stream, the toppers were Chinmay Mahanty with 96.6%, Shruti Arya with 96.4%, and Arjun Roy with 95%. And if I share with you in a nutshell, in the science stream, there were 295 children, 100% pass. 248 children got more than 75% aggregate marks, which is 84.1%. 90% and above was 76, which is around 25.8% children got 90% and above. That is one in each four child. But I must tell you here that the lowest average of our school was around 71%. And the other day I was reading in newspapers, there were a lot of schools whose highest was at 72 and so. But anyways, so this is something which I would like to share with you about the humanities stream. This time it was the second batch. Mugdha Mahapatra got 95.6%, and she stands as the topper in the Bhubaneswar region, with Anish Mishra 95.2% and Anbad Mishra with 95%. So the total number of students in humanities stream were 19, all pass with first divisions, and 90% and above is 6 children, which is 31.6% who got 90% and above. And 16 children got 75% and above, that is close to 84.2%. The school average in humanities was 83.1. These are the highest marks in each subject. In physics, biology, computer science, physical education, and economics, we had a centum as the highest. Whereas rest of the subjects, it was like this. And to share with you, in a nutshell, the report of class 10. Students of class 10, there were 181 students who appeared, and then 171. And then there were CGPA 10 students who got it, around 80 students, which is 47% of the total students who appeared in the class 10 examination got CGPA 10. Nowadays, because the CGPA used to come along with CCE stream. By the way, for your information, CCE is no longer working. CBSE has discontinued with the whole process. So next year onwards, class 10 children will also be appearing in the board examination, and they will get marks like the class 12 children get. So if you see in last few years, since our school has started giving the students for the 10th board examination, which is CCE pattern, this is how the CGPA 10 has been increasing from 8 to 33, and now it stands at 80. So if you see over the years how we have been performing, this is how our performance report is. So the total number of children also is here. So if you see last year, it was 41% children who got CGPA 10. This year it is 47% children who got CGPA 10. So that was a big achievement for our school, and we hope that we'll continue this winning streak. And the feather in the cap was, we had Krishna Sheesh, the NEET state topper of Odisha. I don't know how many of you understand the worth of this, but I must tell you that this is one in a million case. Because this child got 99.86 percentile in NEET examination, which is the AIPMT. He's going to be a doctor finally. But it was such an amazing performance that we were really, really spellbound. He is the Orissa number one. And in fact, all India number 28. And his percentile is 99.86 percentile, which is very, very high. And I'm so proud that we have him from our school. And there were, in fact, not only him, there were other children also. There were total 14 children who have cleared the NEET examination. So those of you who are not in touch with what happens for the medical examination, earlier it used to be called as AIPMT. So to clear the medical entrance examination. Now it is called as NEET. So NEET. So the 14 children who cleared from our school this year and who are going to be the future doctors are these. Similarly, the CLAT toppers. We have Mugdha Mahapatra All India rank 55. So she's going to join NLU Bangalore, and then Amlan Mishra with All India rank 300. And they both have cleared combined law admission test. Similarly, Nitesh Mishra got All India law entrance test, All India rank 2. So he was the second ranker this year. So you can kind of see where the children are going. The top JEE Advanced qualifiers, the children who want to go and join engineering stream and want to join IITs. Ankit Bando with 1,467 rank, Abhay Kumar Sahu and Sarthak Narayan, they both have qualified. And similarly, the total number of children who qualified in JEE Advanced, that is, who are likely to be getting the IITs, are these 13 students. So from this batch, these 13 students are likely to enter into IITs. And then we had some children who, on the basis of very high scores in the board examination, are already admitted in either SRCC, LSR, Hansraj, and top-notch colleges in India. These are those 10 whose results have already been confirmed that they have got the admissions. The admissions are still happening, so we are still counting and updating what is happening and where the children are going. So this is the top 10 colleges students. Similarly, there were the children who want to go for CA, they need to clear the CPT examination. So in the last year, academic year 2016-17, a lot of students of SAI had given the CPT examination. So these are the 11 children who cleared that examination. So they are going to be future CAs. And this is a long list, so it is very small in the font because I could not fit it into it, because this is the list of 45 children who are either going to IIT or National Institute of Technologies, which were earlier called as RECs, Regional Engineering Colleges. So these are the children who have cleared the JEE mains. On the basis of the JEE mains rank, they will get admissions there. So the total number of children which I was showing you is close to 100 out of 400 plus children who appeared in the board examination this year. So almost 25% data is still updated with me, and rest of the data is still being collated. And I hope these children are going to make us proud. And why I share this with you all is because I want you all to be updated, because most of the parents come and tell us and ask us where the children should be going, what should they be doing. So this is how the children are currently doing, because I know your kids, the distance is not very far now. It's only six years, I think. This is all what I had to share with all of you regarding the school's report card. Thank you so much, and thank you once again for coming here.
Good morning, children. Good morning, children. I couldn't hear. Good morning. Very low. Where is the energy? Good morning. This is the maximum. Or still something left. Good morning. Very good. Sit down. Now I feel the hall is with energy. Very good. Are you all happy? But I didn't see the smile. Where is your smile? Are you all happy? Very good. Congratulations to all of you who have made it into this college ceremony today. So children, are you all happy? How happy? How I know that you are happy? No. This time not clap of happiness. Before word of thanks, I want to see all of you happy. And try for next time to be happier. Right? So raise your certificates in both hands. Both hands. Yes, see your parents clapping. Now turn to your right. Both hands, right? Then left.
कुछ पाने की हो आस आस कोई अरमा हो जो खास खास आशाएं हर कोशिश में हो बार बार करे दरियाओं को आर पार आशाएं तूफानों को चीर के मंजिलों को छीन ले आशाएं
Revered Chairman, Sir, Trustee Ma'am, esteemed grandparents and parents, respected principal, respected teachers, and my dear loving students. It gives me immense pleasure to propose a vote of thanks to you all on this glorious occasion where we witness the achievements of the young scholars of the school. Our thanks go, our most honored chairman sir and trustee ma'am who have been constant source of guidance and inspiration to all of us for the cause of education. On behalf of our school, I convey our grateful thanks to all the esteemed parents and grandparents for their gracious presence over here and encouragement.